we talked so much about the broader concepts behind machine learning, let's now dive in and get to the more interesting parts and look at the first machine learning classifier and see how it works under the hood. To keep things simple, let's start with a data set that only consists of one feature variable or measurement. So here on the right-hand side, we see different data points projected onto this measurement or feature variable. And the goal here is to classify which class these points belong to. Also, to keep things simple, we will start with binary classification, which means that there are only two possible labels. Later on, we will extend that and look at multi-label classification. Yeah, and if you think binary classification sounds boring, there are actually a lot of real-world use cases of binary classification, such as spam classification, or if you have photographs where you want to detect whether it shows one object or the other, or in this case, a cat or a dog. And then banks often use a binary process for loan approvals, so whether a loan gets approved or rejected. So now let's return to the problem of binary classification for our feature variable here. So here we have different points labeled on this measurement axis. And now let's add the labels into the picture. So each point has a label either 0 or 1. And if this sounds too abstract, just think about it as spam or not spam, or cat or dog or something like that. So now let's label our points here on the measurement axis. So I'm just introducing how a data set looks like. This is nothing related to machine learning yet. We are just looking at a typical data set. So here we are labeling the points 0 with a blue diamond. And the remaining points are these orange triangles, which correspond to the class label 1. Each point corresponds to one entry in the data set. For example, if we look at the measurement 1.1, this would correspond to this first point here, and so forth. Now that we have a labeled data set, the goal is to predict whether a new data point belongs to the blue diamond or the orange triangle class. For that, we need a decision boundary. So based on our data set here on the left-hand side, a reasonable decision boundary would be at the measurement 4.2. So we can say any new point that falls on the left side of the decision boundary is a blue diamond, and any point that falls on the right side of this decision boundary is an orange triangle. So this way we can use the decision boundary and apply it to new measurements. So yeah, just to emphasize again, the goal of machine learning is really to label new data. So if we are given a new data point, such as this question mark here, placed somewhere between 0 and 4.2, we can use our decision boundary to classify it. And in this case, because it's on the left side of the decision boundary, we would classify it as a blue diamond. So this would be an example of a binary classification task where we have two possible outcomes, class label 0 or class label 1, or in this case, a blue diamond or an orange triangle. So real-world problems often have more than one measurement or feature variable. So here's an example of a two-dimensional data set where we have two measurement axes. In this case, we can also draw a decision boundary. However, now it involves both features. And then when we add another dimension to it, let's say we have three features, and in this case, we would draw a two-dimensional plane to separate these points. And we are looking here at a three-dimensional data set. However, many real-world problems have even higher dimensions. If you think about an image classification problem, each pixel in the image would be one feature. If we have, for example, a 1,000-pixel image, this would be 1,000 features. We can't really visualize this in a plot anymore to draw this decision boundary. However, machine learning and deep learning systems are capable of plotting these decision boundaries in a higher dimensional space that goes, let's say, beyond what we humans can visualize. Now the big question is, how do we learn this decision boundary? Or in other words, how do we teach the machine learning algorithm to come up with this decision boundary automatically? Because that's really what machine learning is all about. It's by deriving these decision boundaries or complex rules to classify data points very accurately by learning from data.